Welcome to the DSpace Anwendertreffen 2020. We are going to talk about DSpace Quiz. In the last years, ForScience supported the DSpace Anwendertreffen every year with a roundtable and or a workshop about DSpace Quiz. It was highly anticipated by the community to have a space where they can not only talk about DSpace, but also specifically about DSpace Quiz. As we have had to move the DSpace Anwendertreffen into a webinar this year, unfortunately, we were not able to do the workshops in a digital way. So we decided to at least get some news about DSpace Quiz here, some specific time for DSpace Quiz. I'm really happy that Andrea from ForScience is joining us today to give a presentation about what's coming to DSpace Quiz. And I'm really happy that so many people joined the webinar today. So Andrea, please go ahead with your talk. Everybody has the possibility to answer, to write questions into the question and answer tools. We will read these questions after the talk.
Hello, thanks Pascal for the introduction. I'm very happy to join virtually my friends in Germany. And we resume from where we left last year in Bamberg and also in Hamburg from Open Repository. So we are working very hard on two different version. One is the current version of DSpace Quiz GLAM, that is the version 5 and 6, and the other is the next version that is also so important, version 7, that will be based on the new Angular REST architecture. I want to give you an overview of what is happening in the last 12 months. The most important development for DSpace Quiz is the compliance with the OpenAI guideline. DSpace Quiz have the wider compliance with OpenAI, with supporting different guidelines. But this year we have added support for the Quiz guideline, the OpenAI guideline for Quiz Manager. So the guidelines that are specific for Quiz system. This is the current picture of all the integration that DSpace Quiz provide with OpenAI. So DSpace Quiz 5 and 6 is compliant with literature version 3 repository guideline as a normal DSpace, but this is an interesting news. Also version 4 is coming. Also, the basic .4 we have for that. In any case, after the release of version .11 or .4, DSpace Quiz will the pull request will be merged in DSpace Quiz. So DSpace, the next DSpace Quiz will be for sure compliant with the, also with the literature version 4 guideline for repository. Other than that, we already have the compliance with the data archive guideline version 2 for OpenAI, and the latest news was the compliance with the Quiz guideline. This Quiz with the OpenAI ecosystem. So it's not limited to information about publication, but you are also able to exchange information about your project, your organization, your people, and so on. I also want to mention that DSpace Quiz support the project API so that you can look up for project detail in the OpenAI database, and you can import this detail. We have support for signposting that is seen as an additional protocol that can help OpenAI to be more effective in the integration. And DSpace Quiz also include out of box the OpenAI statistics plugin. So you only need to ask for an APK to OpenAI, and you will be able to participate in the statistics project from OpenAI to collect normalized data from your repository. Other than that, the other important area where we worked is the ORCID integration. DSpace Quiz already have the full integration with ORCID. You can pull and push almost all kind of information from ORCID. But now we have made some improvement especially we allow to connect your local profile or disconnect also your local profile from ORCID without interference with the login feature. So you can decide to allow the user to log in via ORCID, but this is not anymore a requirement to allow connection of the local profile with ORCID. Now you have the ability to force the push or remove objects from the queue of things that need to be synchronized with ORCID. This is useful to solve some special issue when object was removed directly from the ORCID profile, and this make a discrepancy between the status of the space queries and ORCID. Also, we have improved a lot the logging and the feedback so that both the system administrator and the user is better informed when something goes wrong in the conversation with the ORCID, with synchronization with ORCID. Another important improvement is the, a performance improvement in the lookup. So now you can decide to manage a double way to search in your authority. When you have a remote authority like ORCID, you can decide to provide the user with a fast lookup mechanism that only search for local data and left the room to a separate button to also trigger the remote search. This is because sometimes you only need to search locally, and this will you will save a lot of time because remote query are of course more slow than local query. The other important performance improvement is that in any case, also if you search directly ORCID, now we use multiple threads to retrieve all the detail, and this means that we have more or less an order of improvement, so a 10 times less of time to query ORCID the ORCID registry. Another new feature that has been introduced is the ability to add existing object to a CRIS object. So when you have, for instance, a project as in this screen, and you want to list publication in this project page, you typically need to create a connection between the project and the publication when you deposit the publication. But sometimes you forget about that, and or you need to restore some previous content. In this case, authorized people have a new button, add relation, as you see here, that can be used to search the system about all the existing publication, and you can select which publication need to be added. And of course, also already added publication are flagged in appropriate way so that you can recognize that. Other improvement go in the area of the import of publication from external provider. We have worked on the integration with Web of Science and PubMed to improve the performance or better support the throttling constraint of Web of Science, also manage special additional information like the keyword plus or the article number that is exposed in Web of Science. But the most interesting thing is the last one, so a new provider that we have introduced that is able to check the, your repository before import if the identifier that you are trying to import are already present or not. Sorry. When you do that, the user that try to import, for instance, a DOI that is already in the system will get a notice aside the record that has been found on Crossref or PubMed or things like that, that say this publication is already in the repository. So the submitter can stop immediately without duplicate the record. We have a lot of additional improvements, but I want to mention some of them. We have a new processor that allows you to visualize objects on a Google Maps. You can configure a component to visualize hierarchical relation that is usually typically in the situation of organization unit so that you can visualize the structure of your university, for instance. And we have improved multi-language support for CRIS metadata. so that now you can have in the CRIS object, like in a project, you can have the title in both German and English, and the same for the abstract. And when the user is in the German interface, we'll see only the German value. When it is in the English interface, it will see the English interface, the English value. The improvement here is then if the German version is missing of some value, the user will get in any case the fallback to the English version or vice versa. So this is how the processor look like for the new visualization over a map of object. So in this case, this is the Space CRIS repository from the CRIS organization. They have objects that are named the DRIS, that mean record to describe each specific CRIS system running at an institution. And you see that these information are now drawn on a map, so that you see that there are more than 300 records for Europe. And you can zoom in and get more detail about this cluster, and for instance, to go to see the detail. And one of these records is from Germany, is the Technik University of Hamburg CRIS system that is run on Vispace CRIS also. This is the visualization of the hierarchical structure. So you have a component that can be used to just browse all the structure of your repository or your university, but can be also used inside a specific organization unit so that you can show the substructure of your department or research group and so on. And the nice thing here is that you see some additional icon that can be likely configured so that you can visualize important count fact about this organization. So in this case, this organization have 33 publication, one sub-organization, 12 people enrolled in this organization. We have also made some improvements for the system administrator. I want to mention that the Space CRIS already solved the issue with the GeoLite two distribution policies. It's not anymore possible to download directly from the web the GeoLite database, but you need to set up a separate process. And this have caused trouble with the existing version of the space. This patch is already included in the Space CRIS, so you can build the Space CRIS without trouble. We have also removed some outdated dependency to simplify the development related to how to deal with the Excel file. Now CRIS objects are part of your sitemaps. This improved the search engine indexing, so it's an improvement on the search engine optimization. Your CRIS object will be more visible to Google and other crawler. There is also a command line script now to export CRIS object. It was a feature that was available on the user interface, but not on the command line. This could be useful for some administrative script. And there is also an additional script now that allow you to unsubscribe and in person from all notification. This is something that maybe is also related with the GDPR and needs for the system administrator to remove completely a user from the system or deactivate a user account. So all of that was about the current version of this space, the one that are run by most of the university. But we are also working with some pilot university to build a new DSpace CRIS 7. And we are very happy, and we want to thanks the world DSpace CRIS community, need to thanks the Technical University of Hamburg, particularly for funding and provide continuous support for this project. Also, other institutions are involved in the Space CRIS, and they are again running pilot project on the Space CRIS 7. So I'm very happy to say that, and I look forward to show more in the next month about this institution. Just a final note about the difference between the Space CRIS and the Space 7. The main goal for the Space CRIS 7 is to keep the height reliability and performance that has been proven over years of using production of this software. The Space 7 has opened a bit the room for additional entity and support for some of the key principles of the CRIS system, but is still far from providing complete support for the business process and the real world need of institution. So the Space CRIS 7 aim to provide the same feature that exists in the current version for the institution, so that they can use the Space CRIS 7 for real world CRIS system. The development plan is public on a Google spreadsheet, where you will see which task is in progress, which task is already funded by project, and which tasks stay on the table and are funded by internal development or for science or are looking for supporters. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrea. We already have the first question. Once again, you can put your questions in the question and answer tool in or into the chat. The first question is, visualize objects on a map. Is it only possible with Google Maps or also with OpenStreetMap?
Unfortunately, at this moment, it is bind to Google Maps. But of course, you can adapt the code also to work with OpenStreetMap. It will be useful.
Thank you. Any further questions?
I just want to mention also that all the improvement that you have seen for the Space CRIS all came from you, from the institution. So the way that the Space CRIS is built together with the institution. When we build something for a specific institution, this is contributed back to the community. Also, in some cases, this is directly the source code. In other cases, it's also just idea. For instance, the hierarchical support is something that was initially developed by a developer at Bamberg University. And for science, has worked with Helmut Schmidt University to make it more general and to improve, to clean up a bit the source code and include this feature in the main distribution. So always any improvement is a work of the community as a whole.
We normally do have a lot of questions in the workshop. I'm sorry that we don't have workshops. You have to type in anything you want to ask. The next question would be, will the CRIS module provide REST API access to interact with external systems? I think I would understand
yes,
this question as... I would maybe extend the question a bit. Maybe you can also tell what you changed or what you will add, extend the CRIS API, the REST API with DSpace 7 for DSpace CRIS.
Yes, essentially all the REST endpoint that exists for DSpace 7 exists for DSpace CRIS as well. All the specific feature of DSpace CRIS also will be exposed as a REST API. So the architecture will be exactly the same. One of the important features that the Space CRIS will provide is the ability to synchronize, to easier synchronize information from external system like the HR system with the Space CRIS system. This is a feature that is already in progress for the Space CRIS 7, is listed on Google doc. And so this will be also available.
Yeah, and Beate also put into the chat the link to towards the area of the wiki where we collect, where we gather all the ideas and who's working on which part for DSpace Quiz. Okay, I don't see any further questions. Let's wait another moment. Andrea, thank you very much for your talk. Thank you very much for your contribution for the Anwendertreffen.
Yeah, thank you.
I will stop the recording now. Thanks for coming, for joining us.
Thanks.